this is Matthew with Advantage Technical Services with another quick tip. Today we're going to look at using Onyx Production House to modify and organize your profiles to make them easier to use and more consistent. Now, if you download profiles or if you create your own profiles to get the best possible quality, chances are you've either got a lot of profiles that you don't use on a regular basis, and you've probably also got several media configurations that have one or two profiles that you have to choose that you've downloaded. Now, if that gets frustrating and you have having to remember all of that, you can use the Media Manager to organize all of it to make your life easier. Now, in the Media Library, there's a New Media Group button on the left side of the screen. We're going to create one of those. We're just going to call it Common. You can call it your company name. You can call it whatever you want to. And then from there, we're just going to take profiles that we use regularly and just drag and drop them into our Common folder. Now, once we've got all of our profiles in the Common folder, we can see them and we can modify those profiles simply by right-clicking on them and, say, in this case, renaming it. A lot of times your manufacturer will put a lot of excess information in the media name that you don't need and will really just make it harder to find that profile in the future. Once we've got our Common folder organized, anytime we're in Onyx, we can go into that Common folder and see a list of just the profiles that we use regularly. Now that's a quick and easy way that you can organize profiles, but you can go one step further by modifying the settings for all of your profiles in order to make everything set up so that you even have to do less in the pre-flight stage. Now if you go into Configure Printer, once you're on the Media tab, you can make sure you select your list of Common medias, and then in the Options menu, you can select things like turning on and off your cutter, or other media advanced, things like that, based on whatever printer you're looking at. You've also got mode options, which are settings for specific resolutions and pass modes. Now in there, for this example, we have things like our number of passes, our temperatures, our airflow for our latex printer. But all of the options you could modify normally should be under either options or mode options based on the printer that you're printing with and the profile itself. Once you're done, you click OK to close. Your machine will reinitialize and you're all set to print. Hope this has been helpful and we'll catch you next time.